folks. My name's Julie. I'm from the Ontario Science Center. Just trying to clean up some of my metal artwork here. Early alchemists used to think that we could convert metals from one to another and create gold. What if we could control metal reactions using our knowledge of electrochemistry to create art and to protect metal objects that we use in everyday life?
We can take control of electrochemical reactions to create some beautiful art with metal etching. I'm going to use this metal water bottle because I think it would be really cool to personalize it.
To do metal etching, we'll need a metal object, vinegar, salt, a measuring cup, something to stir with, a small shallow cup, a tablespoon, cotton swabs, scissors, X-Acto knife, pliers, a 9-volt battery, electrical tape or duct tape, anything waterproof, sandpaper, protective glove, a source of electrical wire, which could be reused home wiring, a broken USB or broken headphones, and some kind of clip. First, let's mix our electrolyte solution by measuring 1/4 cup of vinegar and adding to that 2 teaspoons of salt. Stir to mix and transfer to a shallow dish so that your cotton swabs can be dipped easily. Now we're going to make the circuit for our metal etching. We'll need our 9-volt battery. I'm going to strip the plastic sheathing off the ends of 2 pieces of wire and then cook them around both terminals of the battery, covering them with electrical tape. This prevents the chances of a short. You never want to connect 2 wires to 2 terminals of the battery without a load. Next, we're going to connect our cotton swab to the negative terminal of our battery. I'll do this by hooking an end in the wire and putting the swab in, possibly connecting with a clip if needed to keep it secure. The last step to get ready for our metal etching is to create a stencil for the shape that we want to etch onto our metal object. You can use any waterproof tape for this, duct tape or electrical tape. And we're going to create layers of the tape on a cutting mat and then cut out the shape using an X-Acto knife. After that, we will lightly sand our metal object and transfer our stencil to the metal object. Then we'll be ready for plating. To get ready for etching, we're going to take the wire connected to our positive terminal and tape it to our metal object. Then we're ready to start dipping our swab into our solution and pressing it to our metal object.
I brought my etching outside because as I started to do it, I noticed that I've had a faint smell of chlorine, and that's not really safe to inhale. So I've decided it's safer to do this in a well-ventilated area. Let's take a closer look at what's happening in our electric etching. The positive terminal is connected to our metal object, and the negative terminal is connected to our swab soaked in electrolyte solution. On the metal object, we have iron atoms at the surface. When we connect the positive terminal to the iron atoms, it attracts electrons and pulls them through the wire and out of our metal surface. This leaves behind a positive charge on the iron atoms at the surface. This creates a reaction where iron loses electrons to become positively charged iron ions. This is an oxidation reaction, and we label this side of the cell the anode. At the negative terminal, electrons are repelled. The electrons build up a negative charge in our swab. This attracts the iron ions that we've created and pulls them out and dissolves them in the swab solution, leaving behind a gap, which creates the etching. We know that there's also electrolyte solution in the swab. Something you may have noticed is bubbles of gas at the swab. This is caused when the negative electrons building up in the swab react with the hydrogen ions in the acid solution. The hydrogen ions and electrons join together to form hydrogen gas. Altogether, in this electrolytic cell, where we have an anode at the positive terminal and a cathode at the negative terminal, we have created a redox reaction. In a redox reaction, we have both a reduction and an oxidation. In this case, the hydrogen gains electrons to become hydrogen gas and is reduced. The iron loses electrons to become iron ions and is oxidized.
I like this etching result I got on my metal water bottle, but I'm also excited to experiment with more electrochemistry art. I've set up this circuit just the same as we used with our metal etching to electroplate, where instead of removing a metal, I can add a metal. In this case, I'm trying to add copper to another metal object, and I'm using plant fertilizer as my electrolyte because I looked at the label and found out that it contains copper. What metals do you think could be plated with copper? How do you think I set up this circuit to get one metal to plate onto another? Think about which side of the electrochemical cell would I attach the metal I want to plate onto and the metal that I want to plate. Which side of the electric circuit would the metal be attracted to, those positive metal ions in the solution? Now it's your turn. What metals do you think you could etch or plate at home? What concentrations of electrolyte solutions do you think would make it work better or worse? See what you can come up with and share with us at Ontario Science Centre on Instagram. In our companion doc, you'll find more tips and strategies to help you do electric etching and electroplating.